as we look back on this, we're showing the 2008, 2009, and 2010 statement of retained earnings. So as you can see here, 100% statement of earnings, this is statement of net income, excuse me, our net revenues in comparing these 3 years, revenues consistently are at 100%. Everything else is going to be compared to our total revenues. So if you look here at 100% revenues, you see that the cost of sales relative to revenues, 44.7, 44.2, and 41.6. So they were consistent these 2 years. What happened that their cost of sales went down? Did they charge more for their coffee? Then after that, we show the link of operating expenses, 36, 35, 33. We show the other operating expenses, the depreciation, G&A. Look at this, guys. In 2008, the operating income was 4.9, 2009, 5.7, and look at 2010. Why? Then we're dealing with the provision for income taxes. Ultimately, at the end here, our net income per share, or the net income attributable based on net revenues in 2008, 3%, 2009, 4%, and in 2010, 8.8%. So this is, to me, a greater method of really understanding the numbers than looking at these big figures. Do you see what I'm saying?
I know what they did then. They started doing some products in the stores, like instant coffee.
In
2010? Yeah.
They obviously invested in some of them.
I went to Guatemala that year and they're giving out samples of instant coffee and I took it with me. And the next year they started selling them on the market.
So basically, I don't know. It'd be interesting to see what was the big change. Definitely, I was hoping I could just see something that says, boom.
I know they came out some new products of that year.
Well, if it's non-controlling interest, that's exactly why they have another company, correct?
Well, and they, but you know, their gross profit increased so much, which means, you know, usually you think of efficiency. And they really weren't in a place to necessarily purchase, or excuse me, necessarily increase the price. You know, that was just coming out of the recession.
Did coffee bean prices fall?
Something had to have happened.
I think they just started a marketing campaign and just added the product, I mean, added a new product that was.
And I know when we just went on a cruise, they had a Starbucks on the cruise ship. So they've started these Starbucks at sea. You know, who knows? I mean, they're so huge, 180,000 employees. I can't even relate.
Would there be some on the notes to shareholders if you were to look at that?
Probably. You guys are going to email me what happened. Okay, so as we move on here, various ratios that we're going to pay attention to. Return on common equity. We're not going to go through some of these. I'm just going to go through the ones. Return on common equity basically is the return, which is the net income divided by the average shares of common stock outstanding. Net revenues, earnings quality, earnings management. Not going to worry about all that. Reportable segments. We're not going to worry about interim financial statements. I basically want you to know about the income statement, and then we're going to look at the statement of cash flows. So the problem you said was 16, problem 8 and 16, guys?
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yes.
So let's go and look at number 16. What page is that on, guys?
582.
Thank you. So, statement of cash flows. The following are several items involving Mueller Company's cash flow activities for 2013. So we are going to prepare a statement of cash flows. Now, I do want to say, for the quiz, be familiar with what we're going over in class. You'll probably have an income statement that you'll have to complete, just like that problem. And you may have problems similar to this, say, giving you a couple items and showing this item should fit under which section, okay? So let's start with this statement of cash flows. The following are items involving Mueller's company cash flow. Net income, we show our increase in accounts receivable, our receipt from sale of common stock, depreciation, dividends, payment for purchase of building, bond discount, receipt for sale of long-term investments at cost. Where's our increase in accounts receivable going to go?
Operating.
Receipt from sale of common stock?
Financing.
Depreciation expense? Dividends. Payment for purchase of building?
Investing.
Yes, investing. Bond discount amortization?
Operating.
Receipt from sale of long-term investments at cost?
Finance.
Investing. Payment for purchase of equipment?
Investing.
Investing. Receipt from sale of preferred stock?
Financing.
Increase in income taxes payable? Payment for purchase of land?
Investing.
Decrease in accounts payable?
Operating.
Increase in inventories?
Operating.
Beginning cash balance?
Operating.
The bottom.
Okay,
so let's prepare one of these, okay, guys? So let's start in here, and we're going to go and create a new Excel and start with our title. If there's one thing I want you to remember, the title is the most important item to begin any financial statement with. So this is Mueller Company. What is it? Statement of cash flows. And what is it for the period ending? For the year ended? December 31st, 2013. So what are we going to start with? Operating activities. Okay, what's the first section of the cash flows? Operating activities. We're going to start with net income. What was our net income, guys?
$68,000.
So we start with $68,000 here. What's next?
Increase of accounts receivable.
So we're going to adjustments for non-cash income items. Okay? We're going to first start with at additions. What are some non-cash items we're going to add?
Accounts receivable.
Depreciation expense. How much? $11,300. What about the bond discount amortization? We showed that, but we really didn't handle any cash, did we? That bond discount amortization is just allocating the expense throughout the time. So what are we going to add back? Bond discount amortization of how much? Bond discount amortization of $2,700. Okay, so those were our non-cash items. So now we're going to do adjustments for cash flow on assets and liabilities, okay? What are we going to start here with? Increase in accounts receivable. Our increase in accounts receivable is actually going to be subtracted from cash. Why? Because if our accounts receivable, okay, remember, sorry, I don't have my shoes on. Everything is to do with net income. We're thinking of everything as a result of net income, okay? So if our net income here is $68,000, and if our accounts receivable started with, let's say, how much did they go up, guys? From what to what? I'm sorry?
$4,500?
$4,400.
Let's say they were at 5,000 and they ended up going to 9,400. Okay? Then help me just think this through. At the beginning of the period, this $5,000 was really showing up as sales in the previous year. This money came in 2013, even though these sales were for 2012, weren't they?
Mm-hmm.
Now, we end